Hello, boys and girls. I really miss getting to see you in the tea hall each week, but I'm glad that you decided to join us for Explorers anyway tonight. We have a lesson for you and some songs and a memory verse, but first we want to pray. So let's pray together. Let's talk to Jesus. Lord, thank you for another day, for this time to meet and learn together. I ask that you would bless each one of these boys and girls. Be with them today and throughout this week. Help us tonight as we learn. In your name we pray. Amen. Well, I hope you're ready to learn and sing. Let's learn together.
Let's sing, "I Have Decided to Follow Jesus." Son of Encouragement. Does anyone know what it means to have a nickname? A nickname is a special name someone gives you because it tells something good and special about you. The man in our Bible story today had a great nickname. The name his mom and dad gave him was Joseph, but the disciples gave him a very special nickname, Barnabas. Barnabas means Son of Encouragement. They gave Barnabas this nickname because he encouraged everyone with kind words and good deeds. Listen how he encouraged a man named Saul. Saul had tried to hurt and arrest believers before Jesus came and spoke to him in a vision. Now he believed that Jesus was the promised hero and king. He told everyone everywhere about Jesus. Saul talked about Jesus so much that he made many people angry. His friends helped him escape the angry people in the city of Damascus by lowering him in a basket down the city walls. Saul went to Jerusalem, but many people were still afraid of him. They remembered that Saul had tried to arrest them because they loved Jesus. "Saul is trying to trick us," they said. They would have nothing to do with him. Saul was sad. He needed someone to encourage him. Someone who would believe him and say good things about him. God sent someone to Saul. Who do you think that person was? That's right, Barnabas. Saul told his story to Barnabas. Barnabas believed him. Barnabas took Saul to meet the other disciples. The disciples knew Barnabas well, and they believed his encouraging words about Saul. Barnabas explained how Jesus himself had talked to Saul and given him the job of teaching people about the good news. Now the disciples were excited. They welcomed Saul and taught him all they knew about Jesus. Barnabas continued to encourage Saul, and they became good friends. One day, the Holy Spirit told Barnabas and Saul that they had a new job: to tell people who were not Jews about Jesus. Barnabas and Saul went on long journeys together to teach about Jesus. Sometimes the two men were in danger because crowds did not want them to teach the good news. They traveled on ships, on donkeys, and they walked and walked. Barnabas always encouraged Saul and other new Christians. He made them feel great by telling kind truths about them, by believing in them, and by doing good things for them. God can help us encourage each other too. What are some ways that we can be encouragers? We can build others up with true words like, good job, Jesus loves you, I love your smile, and others. Could you encourage people so much that they would give you a nickname like Barnabas? I bet you could. When you always point out the good things in others, you will be an encourager, just like Barnabas.
Prayer is such an important part of our relationship with God, and all we have to do is remember we can talk to Him anytime and anywhere about anything. We're going to sing, Did You Ever Talk to God About?
Story called Stage Fright. Good morning, evening, ladies and gentlemen. Paul Shepherd stood on the school stage and felt ready to cry. His hands were sweaty and he kept forgetting the words that he was supposed to say. Just relax, Paul. You're doing fine. Miss Raymond, his teacher, smiled kindly. Paul didn't feel like he was doing fine. He didn't know how he was supposed to relax. It was scary being up on stage, and this was only a practice. His class was putting on a play for everybody's parents and families. Mrs. Raymond had chosen Paul to be the narrator. He was very worried about getting up in front of all those people. What if he messed up the whole play? Then everyone would be mad at him. Paul wished for the 100th time that they weren't doing this play. Okay, children, that's enough practice for today, Miss Raymond said. Let's go back to the classroom and do some math. Some of the kids groaned. The rest of the day, Paul could hardly focus on his work. He kept thinking about the play and how scared he was. He thought about it all the way home. Once he was home, Paul went straight to his room. He even turned down the hot and gooey cookies his mom offered him. They were straight from the oven. But his stomach felt funny. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, he said. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. He repeated it a little louder. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Louder still. Paul? What are you doing? Paul jumped. His brother leaned against the door and looked at him. Oh, hi, Mark. You scared me. Paul plopped down on his bed and let out a sigh. Our class is doing a play, and I'm supposed to be the narrator, but every time I get up on the stage, I get nervous and forget what to say. I'm scared that I'm really going to mess up. I see, said Mark. You're experiencing stage fright. That's pretty common. Stage fright? Paul asked. That's right. Lots of people get really scared and nervous about speaking or performing in front of people, but you know what? What? I know that you will do just fine. How do you know that? Paul asked doubtfully. Because I'm your brother, and I know you pretty well. I know that you are smart, and you always do what needs to be done, Mark told him. Paul felt a little better, but he was still anxious. I've never had to speak in front of a whole bunch of people before. How do you know I can do it? How do you know that I won't forget my lines? I'm sure that you will practice and practice because you are a hard worker. And I also know that God will help you, Mark smiled. Think about all the times that he has helped you in the past. Then you will see that he will continue to help you. Before you go on stage, be sure to pray. That's a good idea, Paul said. Plus, Mark added, you can look for me in the audience. I'll give you a wink and a big thumbs up to get you started, like this. Mark made a funny face and held his thumbs up in front of him. Paul laughed. Now, Paul felt much better. He was happy to learn how a few kind words could do so much to help. Wow, you're right, Mark. Thanks for encouraging me. Will you help me practice my lines? You bet. Now move over so that I can have a seat on your bed. Mark plopped down beside his brother and ruffled his hair. Paul was glad his brother took time to encourage him. He was ready to do this play.
Let's sing about our great big God.
My God is so big, so strong, and so mighty. There's nothing my God cannot do for you. My God is so big, so strong, and so mighty. There's nothing my God cannot do. The mountains are his, the rivers are his, the stars are his handiwork too. My God is so big, so strong, and so mighty. There's nothing my God cannot do for you.
Our verse for tonight says, therefore, encourage one another and build one another up, just as you are doing. 1 Thessalonians 5:11. Tonight, boys and girls, we have a song we'd like to share with you to help you to memorize this verse. But let's try saying it one more time together. Therefore, encourage one another and build one another up, just as you are doing. 1 Thessalonians 5:11. Let's try it again. Therefore, encourage one another and build one another up, just as you are doing. 1 Thessalonians 5:11. All right, we're ready to hear our song.
Words are very powerful. They can either build us up or tear us down. Every day, we can encourage others with words like, you're special, good job, or keep trying, you're gonna make it.
From 1 Thessalonians 5, verse 11, encourage one another and build each other up.
Encourage one another.
Now, just like encouraging words build us up, discouraging words tear us down. So another way of singing this song would be like this.
Encourage one another, don't tear each other down. Tear each other down, tear each other down. Encourage one another, don't tear each other down. Down, 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 down.
Okay. Now sing it again the way the Bible says it.
Encourage one another and build each other up. Build each other up. Build each other up. Encourage one another and build each other up. Up, 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 up.
Boys and girls, thank you so much for joining us tonight. It's been so fun to learn with each of you and to grow with you and to sing with you. Let's close our eyes and bow our heads, and we're going to talk to God one more time. Lord, thank you so much for this night. Thank you for what we've learned from Miss Fuller. Would you help us, God, to encourage others with our words and to build one another up and not tear one another down? We love you, Lord. Thank you for your help. And we're so excited about soon, hopefully, getting back together in church. We can't wait. Thank you, Lord, for your help during this time. We love you. Amen. Boys and girls, if you would like to, right at the end tonight, please grab a piece of paper and you can draw a picture or maybe write a note of encouragement to someone else. God can use you to be a blessing to someone in your family or someone who lives nearby. You can drop that note in the mail and send it to someone, or maybe drop it by their house, leave it on their porch. It'll be exciting to see how you can encourage others. Have a happy week. We love and miss you.